Cindy Lou Hensley was born on 20 May 1954 in Phoenix, Arizona, in the United States, into a relatively wealthy family, and is perhaps best known as the wife of former presidential candidate and U.S. Senator John McCain, but importantly, as a significant businesswoman in her own right. So, just how rich is Cindy McCain as of mid-2017? Cindy's net worth is estimated by Celebrity.Money to be over $110 million, accumulated by this highly efficient businesswoman and philanthropist during her working life in business, which began in the 1980s. What parents wouldn't wish their child to be born with a silver spoon in their mouth? While Arizona folks enjoyed sipping cool beer from Anheuser-Busch factories, Cindy McCain's father did his best to quench their thirst, gradually making it to the top in the beer distribution business long before Cindy entered the world as the only daughter to the James and Marguerite Hensley family. James founded Hensley & Company, which was profitable enough to gain the family affluent standards of living, as well as funding Cindy's education. After finishing Central High School in 1972, Cindy left Phoenix for the University of Southern California, graduating from it with a Bachelor's of Arts degree in education in 1976 and a Master's of Arts in Special Education in 1978. Her academic years led to work as a special education teacher, which experience resulted in the publication of her study, Movement Therapy, a Possible Approach, aimed at improving the treatment standards of severely disabled children. This success added to Cindy's net worth, but the strong charity traditions of her social stratum and her personal commitment led to the foundation of American Voluntary Medical Team in 1988, a nonprofit organization which provided medical help in Micronesia, Vietnam, Iraq, Nicaragua, India, Bangladesh, and more. Subsequently, in 1995, the Hensley Family Foundation was established, and thereafter Cindy frequented war and poverty-stricken regions in the third world countries as a board member of Operation Smile, Eastern Congo Initiative, and the Halo Trust. Her attention focused on humanitarian aid, global economic crises, and struggles with sex trafficking. However, after her father's death, she gained the controlling position at Hensley & Company as its chair, which along with the business aspects greatly expanded both her assets and opportunities for donating to several humanitarian projects, home and abroad. Obviously, her net worth received a big boost. Presuming that a woman's marriage equals her birth and consequences, fate favored Cindy by presenting her with the second silver spoon in 1980 when her wedding to John McCain took place. Since 1984, the couple has been blessed with three children, and a fourth, a victim of the Bangladesh cyclone, was adopted in 1991. Meanwhile, Cindy continued to support her husband both morally and financially on his way towards the apex of his political career as a Republican representative in the United States Senate, followed by his nominations for presidential candidate in 2000 and 2008. Unfortunately, even the most admirable ones occasionally walk under clouds. Soon after her wedding to newly divorced John McCain, her social life was overshadowed by his ex-wife Caroline, whose influence and popularity initially contributed to Cindy being rejected by the White House community. Also, during exhaustive service at AVMT, she developed an addiction to painkillers due to recurrent severe migraines, opting for illegally prescribed medicine. She subsequently regretted her misconduct publicly, proclaiming her will to help pain sufferers with similar addiction to face and combat the problem. Also, the McCains were involved in the notorious Keating 5 bank scandal. Still speaking of clouds, it seems that most of them had a silver lining for Cindy, as she kept on pursuing her goals with stamina and perseverance, particularly with regard to sex trafficking, child abuse, and prostitution. More than once, she has been compared to Mother Teresa and Lady Diana. In the end, great givers become great gainers. Cindy and John McCain are still based in Arizona.